In today's video, we're going to talk about, is Google's data analytics certificate by Coursera still worth it in 2023? Google data analytics certificate launched back in 2021 and it immediately took off. Every person was talking about it. I mean, all the data creators were talking about it. Pretty much every person that focuses on data science domain or data analytics space talked about this certificate. As of today of recording this video, there are about 1.5 million people who have enrolled in the certificate over the last 2 years. So this certificate has completely taken off. However, there are some critiques to the certificate, if this certificate is enough to landing a job. So I wanted to specifically dedicate this video and talk about if this certificate is still worth it in 2023, considering there are so many other options out there in the market. So in this video, I'm going to be sharing my honest opinion on the certificate. Yes, I was part of the certificate. Some of you probably seen me in the certificate and found me on this channel or found me on LinkedIn. But the original video where I shared my detailed review, I did share my unbiased opinion, and I'm going to do exactly that in this video as well. This video is also sponsored by Coursera, and I'm really grateful that they're giving me creative freedom to share my honest opinion on the certificate itself. So thank you, Coursera, for sponsoring this video and also letting me be me. I'm going to break down this video into three sections. One is a brief overview of the certificate. Second, we're going to talk about who should take this certificate and who should not. Yes, I have a list of people who should not take the certificate. And the last thing I want to focus on is if this certificate is enough to help you land a job. And if it's not, then what else you should be doing. So stick around and let me know in comments your thoughts throughout the video. I'm linking the course in the description. So if you are not of one of those 1.5 million people who have enrolled in the course, this is something to consider. So a brief overview of the course. Basically, this certificate is created by Google. It's offered through Coursera. At the moment of recording this video, there are about 1.5 million people who have already enrolled in the certificate. So it's pretty popular. This just happened in the last 2 years. And it has over 103,000 rating, and it has been rated as 4.8 out of 5, which is a pretty good rating. The suggested time period to complete the certificate is 6 months. It takes, the average cost of taking the course is $39 per month. It's a very beginner level course, and then you get to earn credits after finishing this course toward a university program. There are 8 courses in the certificate, and the courses are designed as if you are working on a data analytics project. So it starts with like foundation to asking the right set of questions, finding data, cleaning data, presenting data and preparing data and all of that. That part I actually really, really like about the course. It does focus on teaching in SQL and R, and I know that's one of the concerns for some people, that why is it doesn't teach in Python. We'll definitely talk about that in a few minutes. I'm gonna link the course in the description if you want to take a look at it in your own time. And if you wanna watch a detailed review of the course, you can actually watch this video where I cover in a lot more detail and I go through like each course by course and I go inside the course as well. Looking at Grow with Google website where this course is highlighted, they have shown that an average entry-level salary for data analytics is $74,000. I do wanna look at the data source for that. And they also mentioned that 380,000 jobs are available in the data analytics space. I wanted to see if they updated it, because if this is still leveraging last year, it looks like they looked at the Burning Glass Labor Insights during the last 12 months and from February 1st, 2021 to January 31st, 2022. I would definitely love to see like an updated data source and see how things are trending recently and how the market has shifted and data analytics demand has shifted. So definitely something to look into. Coursera actually did a research recently where they surveyed 5,000 people. They basically found that people who have taken micro courses, certificates, have found value in their career progression. And employers were interviewed as part of this survey also expressed that they actually look for skill-based learning, and they also ask the companies if certificates and micro learnings are helpful, and 88% of the employers agree or strongly agree that the professional certificate strengthens a candidate's application. So in terms of who should take it and who should not take it, okay, this is an important part of determining if this certificate is worth it. So this certificate is pretty introductory. It is designed for people who are new to the data analytics space. So who should take it? Take it if you are new to data analytics, want flexible and affordable option. Yes, there are a lot of other options out there. There are boot camps that are charging upward of $6,000, $7,000. Considering that, this is relatively cheaper. So if you're looking for a more affordable alternative, like this is a good option. You should take it if you're not sure data analytics career is right for you and you want to try it out and get hands-on experience, you should consider that certificate. So here, example, one of my coworkers in the sister team wanted to get into data analytics, and this is actually the course that I recommended to them because it does do a really good job for somebody who has no experience background in the data analytics space and they want to get an exposure. So this does a really, really good job of that. Okay, so these are the people that should take this. Now, who should not take this course? As I said, that this course is a pretty introductory course. You would not find as much value from this course if you are already working in the data analytics domain. If you're looking for advanced data analytics material, the third type of people who should not take this course is if you prefer different style of learning. For example, this course is very video heavy. So if you prefer other forms of learning, such as like reading through text, and this course might not be a right fit for you. Although there are a lot of learning material, but a large chunk of the course is video based. So that's something to keep in mind. Okay, so hopefully this makes it clear who should take the course and who should not take the course. Now, I quickly want to talk about Python versus R because that's always a concern that comes up. Yes, the course does teaches in R, it doesn't teach in Python. And I wish it had done focused on Python instead of R. As you probably already know from an industry knowledge that Python is actually taking off. Python is a good language to learn, but R is also not a bad one to learn. Yes, I do wish that this course had Python, but R is something that what I learned when I was starting out in my career in the data science domain. And R, I have found it, even though I know Python now and I do my projects in Python, I still find myself using R from time to time where I have to do something quick and dirty. And I can use my RStudio to like do a quick analysis, or if I need a specific statistics library, then R is useful. And I can understand why Google may have picked R over Python, because they are not going deeper into the language. They're only covering at the high level, and only a very small portion of the course is dedicated to R. I believe there's like one course out of the 8 courses. So if that is a big concern for you, if you really, really want to know Python, then I would suggest like you can either go with another option that has Python integrated if you really want to learn Python, or you can continue with this course, get introduced to R, and then take a dedicated course that is focused on Python for data analysis. Because I will tell you, no matter which data analytics course you take, if the coding is a small segment of the course, it's never going to be able to go deeper. So the chances are that even taking another course that focuses on Python, you're going to still have to take another Python course to kind of like develop your skills in it. So that's something to keep in mind. But yeah, if coding language is a big concern for you, then consider alternative options. I would say that 80% of the work should be SQL only. And again, like this course does go into SQL, but I think you would have to take another course that is specifically dedicated to SQL to be able to like fully develop your skills. Is it still worth it in 2023? The short answer is yes. The long answer is that if you're one of the people in the buckets that I mentioned, then this is definitely a great option. It's a well-structured course, and there are not many alternative affordable options out there. So this lets you tap into data analytics and see if this is something a good fit for you at a very affordable cost, instead of committing for something that is like $7,000 or $8,000 when you're not even sure that data analytics is for you. And yes, there are free material on YouTube, and there are structured, you can structure your own learning material. But the thing is, like, if you are somebody who can come up with your own learning material and create your own roadmap, then you probably are already familiar with the data analytics space and you don't even need to take this course. The reality is that a lot of people who start in data analytics, they actually don't know where to get started. So that's where a structured approach, somebody who has already figured out the roadmap, could be super, super helpful in terms of determining what they should learn next. So this could actually set the foundation for you to like continue your learning journey and get a certificate on top of it. You can take this course by itself, which is about $39 a month, or you can also consider Coursera Plus, which lets you take hundreds of courses on Coursera's website, including Google's Data Analytics Certificate. So that's also another option. I'm going to link that below as well. So definitely consider it if you're planning to take more than one course on Coursera. Coursera Plus could be a more, better way to optimize your money when it comes to learning. The last portion of this video is dedicated to how to land a job with a certificate. I really wanted to dedicate a large portion of this video to this topic specifically because I think there are some misconceptions that people have that with this certificate or any certificate in general, people think that if you take any certificate, recruiters will be after you, you will be getting messages, you will be getting emails, and once you finish the certificate or any other certificate and you don't get those callbacks, then you're wondering, is the certificate worth it? So here, let me actually share from my personal story. When I started my career in the data science domain, one of the things that my counselor told me is that at the end of the 4 year, every person is going to graduate with a degree. And when you're looking for a job, the company is looking at candidate A and candidate B. And candidate A has a degree, candidate B has a degree. Candidate A doesn't have any experience or projects. Candidate B has some experience or projects. Who is the company going to pick? Are they going to pick candidate A or candidate B? Of course, they're going to pick candidate B. So same applies here. As we saw earlier in the video, there are about 1.5 million people who have enrolled in the certificate and possibly have completed the certificate. So everybody who's enrolled in the certificate is going to complete the certificate. What are you going to do to stand out in the job market? This certificate is not any different from any of the degree program. After you finish the certificate, you actually have to get more experience doing data analytics work to show that you can actually do the work. Once you finish the certificate, you actually now need to go and apply those skill set through various projects so you can like start building your project portfolio and you can add those projects to your resume, to your GitHub, or wherever you are showcasing your work. So then the recruiters and the hiring managers can see that you can actually do the work. There are two major benefits to doing this. One, when you do more projects, when you get more hands-on experience, you actually solidify your skills, your learning. So basically you get to retain the knowledge for a longer period of time when you actually do hands-on work. Two, you get to build your project portfolio so you can show it to your recruiters, to hiring managers. You can highlight it on your GitHub, on your resume, and you have something to talk about in those interview settings because when you have completed multiple projects, when those interviewers are asking questions, you actually have something to share. So in terms of picking the project, what I would suggest after you finish the certificate, focus on domain areas that you are interested in. For example, let's say if you want to get into e-commerce, then you would pick a domain area and you pick the data set and problems that you're trying to solve are specific to the e-commerce, something that an e-commerce would struggle with. For example, let's say if you want to become a data analyst at Amazon, that's your end goal. In this case, you would focus on doing data analyst projects, picking a data set that is focused on e-commerce, solving e-commerce problems. For example, let's say you find a data set on Kaggle where the problem is that you need to find trends in customers' purchasing history and understand if there's seasonality. And your job is to find trends in the data, build a dashboard, and present to business stakeholders. So this is an example of one project. So as you pick your project, make sure that you're highlighting different skills that the data analyst has. For example, this one was focused on like finding trends and building dashboard. Another project could be focused on like data cleaning or data manipulation. A third project could be focused on experimentation, A/B testing. So kind of like build your project portfolio that cover a variety of area of the data analyst domain so you can show it on your portfolio. So some of the resources that I like to share for free data set is Kaggle, Google Data Search, Analytics Vidya for finding problems to solve with data. And finally, once you have built your project portfolio, start for interview prep. I have mentioned in so many other videos, like interview prep is a completely different monster in itself. So you need to practice, you need to spend time learning to be able to, not only once you get the call, you can actually do the interview successfully to land the job. So some resources for interview prep that I love to use is Lead Code, Strata Scratch. Google also has a interview prep for data analytics specifically. It's called Interview Warm-Up, where they cover a variety of job families and data analytics. So by doing all of this, this prepares you for the real world, for the job market. Especially in today's world, job market is pretty competitive. And the better you can highlight your skill set, the better you can showcase that you know something is going to help you stand out in the job market with this certificate or any other certificate. Anyways, I said I wanted to dedicate a big portion of this video to talking about how to land a job because that's one of the common concerns that keeps coming up. And I hope this portion of the video has clarified that for you. So let me know in comments your thoughts on the Google Data Analytics Certificate Program. Have you taken that? Are you considering it? If you have taken that, what are your thoughts? Let me know in comments. And if you have successfully landed a job, I would love to know. Please leave in comments, what did you do to help stand out? Because that could help somebody else who is watching this video and they're curious about learning about Google's Data Analytics Certificate. And I completely forgot. Oh my God. I got this shirt out. So this is a shirt that I wear, which I actually recorded my first Google data analytics video. So we're gonna put that on quickly.